Hey everyone, sometime back I put out a video on whether or not you should run your CPU without thermal paste. Go check out that video if you haven't already done so, where the Ryzen 5 3600 and my own personal PC goes to real toasty temperatures on the stock AMD Wraith Stealth heatsink while under load. Today, we'll attempt to fix that, where I've bought for myself the ID Cooling SE-226-XT Black CPU cooler in the hopes that it'll bring temperatures down to more manageable levels. Now, ID Cooling is a Chinese company that's based out of Shenzhen, and their products have been taking the CPU cooler market by storm, where their budget-priced offerings have been putting up a real challenge against pricier offerings from more branded manufacturers. We'll unbox the CPU cooler and do a couple of tests to see how it measures up. Let's get cracking. First things first, the packaging. The SE-226-XT comes in a black and orange box, with brief mentions on the specs of the CPU cooler spread out on the sides of the box. I really like the packaging, especially given the minimalism and color combination, which, in my opinion, work pretty well. Opening up the packaging, we see that the cooler is very securely packaged with multiple sections. First up, we get an installation guide, which is always handy. Moving on, removing this center cardboard divider here reveals the CPU cooler, which we'll take a closer look at later in the video. Now, if we were to take a quick peek at this box, we see that it contains the 120mm fan that goes onto the CPU cooler. This other box right here contains the mounting brackets, screws, and other accessories that come included with the cooler. And with these out of the way, we're now able to remove the cooler from the box. And you'll notice that the cooler rests on a foam base for added protection. Let's take a closer look at the fan that's included with the SE-226-XT. As mentioned earlier, it's a 120mm part with model number TF12025 black, and is also sold separately by ID Cooling should you wish to order an additional fan. It's fully black in color to match the appearance of the CPU cooler and has a 9-bladed design. It also employs hydraulic bearings, supports PWM, and has rubber dampeners that you can see right here on all four corners of the fan frame, which should go a long way in reducing noise output. Onto the box of accessories, we see that ID Cooling's included quite a fair bit of kit here, especially when it comes to mounting bracket options. The SE-226-XT supports an extensive range of processor platforms, from the latest LGA1700 socket for Intel's 12th generation Alder Lake processors, to AMD's AM4 platform for its Ryzen processors, to even the venerable LGA 1156 platform, which was used for Intel's first generation Nehalem Core i5 and i7 processors from 14 years ago. Mounting accessories aside, ID Cooling's also included 4 fan clips, which is great especially if you like to have the option of installing a second fan on the CPU cooler tower. We also do get a large tube of thermal paste from ID Cooling with model number IDTG25. And apart from this, we also do get an ID Cooling case badge right here, which I suppose is a welcome bonus to have. With that, here's the SE-226-XT Black in its full glory. As its name implies, it's fully black in color and is a pretty solid feeling product that certainly inspires confidence. According to ID Cooling's blurb on their website, the cooler has microwave patterns that provide a larger surface area for heat dissipation, ergo, better thermal performance, I suppose. Moving over to the top of the CPU cooler, we see that there's a black plastic shroud which also covers the 6 heat pipes that the CPU cooler comes with, and the finishing of this black plastic shroud is pretty nice. One of the features of this cooler is the fact that the tower assembly is offset, such that end users shouldn't face any issues with RAM clearance, which is fantastic. You'll also see a notch right here, which is also to account for users who may be using this cooler on workstation motherboards with RAM slots on both sides of the socket, which is really thoughtful as well. The base of the SE-226-XT Black is made out of copper and, as you can see, has a circular machined finish. The accompanying heat pipes are also finished in black to round up the black color scheme of the CPU cooler. As mentioned earlier, I'll be testing the SE-226-XT with my AMD Ryzen 5 3600 processor, which uses the AM4 socket. Since I already have an open tube of ArcTech MX4, I'll be using that together with the SE-226-XT. Let's get cracking with the installation. And here it is, the SE-226-XT installed on my ASRock X570M Pro 4 motherboard together with the AMD Ryzen 5 3600 processor. Now, to put the CPU cooler through its paces to see how it performs, I'll be doing a CPU stress test using Cinebench R23, and this will be followed by the free version of DaVinci Resolve R17, where I'll be rendering a video in DaVinci Resolve. Thereafter, I'll be running Far Cry 5's built-in benchmark feature so as to round things up. Before we begin, these are the specs of my PC for this test. The ambient temperature of my surroundings as of the test is approximately 30 degrees Celsius with no air conditioning. At the end of these tests, I'll compare the SE-226-XT's results with the stock AMD Wraith Stealth results that I obtained from a similar volley of tests that I did from one of my earlier videos, the one on running my PC with and without thermal paste, and this is so as to quantify the thermal performance improvements. With that, my PC nets a score of 8,617 for Cinebench R23's multi-core test, with an average temperature of 79 degrees Celsius, a maximum temperature of 80 degrees Celsius, and a low of 60 degrees Celsius. Moving on to DaVinci Resolve 17, I rendered one of my older YouTube videos, an iPhone unboxing feature, and it completed the render in 1 minute and 21 seconds, while achieving an average temperature of 74 degrees Celsius, a maximum temperature of 75 degrees Celsius, and a low of 62 degrees Celsius. On to the Far Cry 5 built-in benchmark. The Ryzen 5 3600 achieved an average temperature of 67.5 degrees Celsius, a high of 69 degrees Celsius, and a low of 66 degrees Celsius. Now, if we were to compare these results against those which I got with the stock AMD Wraith Stealth cooler from my previous video on operating a PC with and without thermal paste, we can see a significant improvement in thermal performance, so much so that I've also managed to get significantly better PC performance in 2 out of the 3 tests. Look at this, I've gotten a higher score in Cinebench R23 and shaved off close to 2 minutes of render time with DaVinci Resolve 17. While I've gotten an additional 1 FPS in Far Cry 5, this can be considered to be negligible, average temperatures during the benchmark fell by more than 10 degrees Celsius. Phenomenal. Also goes to show really how important it is to have a good CPU cooler, as thermal throttling, which obviously happened while I was running these tests with the stock AMD cooler, can significantly impair your PC's performance, where processor clock speeds are reduced once TJ Max is hit. In conclusion, I'm very pleased with the ID Cooling SE-226-XT Black. It's a beefy CPU cooler that is well made, comes with a great set of accessories, and more importantly, does its job pretty well while staying relatively quiet. To top things off, it also has a pretty decent price tag. As of July 2022, the SE-226-XT is going for a price of around SGD 59 on major e-commerce platforms in Singapore, which roughly translates to around $42 for you international folks. One downside, however, is the lack of availability in countries outside of Asia, which could translate into higher prices once you factor in international shipping costs, which would then affect the price-to-performance ratio for this CPU cooler. With that, thank you so much for watching, get subscribed if you found this video helpful, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.